Hey guys, this is Kaja and welcome back to another video. Today I'll be doing a tutorial on how to make a jump for your traditional Breyer horses. This is a very basic jump, but I think it looks a lot better than, you know, kind of your standard plastic jump that comes with Breyer sometimes. I don't even know anymore. It just broke, okay? So what you're going to need is a model horse to help with sizing. I'm using Soncella, who's on the Lady Phase mold, because it's kind of a moderate size mold, not compared to like Lonesome Glory, who's way too tall, or like the Shetland Pony, that's just way too tiny. It's just find a good moderate size mold. If you have a horse on the jumping mold, I forgot what it was called, but it's like the jumping horse in the actual action of jumping over the jump, you should definitely use that, but I don't have that, so we're just going with this. The next thing you're going to need is popsicle sticks. These are going to be used to make the jump standards and kind of, I forgot what it's called, but they like hold in the actual poles. You're also going to need little stubs or just leftovers from a previous project. You're also going to need just wooden dowels of some sort. I'm using the super thin ones. If you want, you could also use like the thick ones or anything in between. You could use two or three, doesn't really matter. And you're also going to need a hot glue gun, some sharp scissors. You could probably use normal scissors too. This is just more hot glue. And a ruler. And sandpaper. So those are all the necessary items that you are going to need, but you could also paint your jump if you want. I'm painting the standards white. And then I'm doing a white and red and blue pattern. I'm running out of space here. Just like a striped pattern similar to these jumps. Similar pattern on the pole. And then, of course, a paintbrush. And to make your lines exact, some painter's tape or just normal tape. Alright, so let's get started. The first thing that you're going to want to do is pick the proper size for your jump. Now, you may want to use reference pictures of horses jumping or just like simple jumps in general to base your sizes off. Again, this is definitely why we're using a moderate size Breyer. My belief is that these jumps are actually pretty good size if you compare it to the Breyer. I mean, that's a decently sized jump. And the popsicle sticks that I'm using for the jump standards are just a little bit larger. So I think that's fine. These are actually, like, I think for... let me put that down for a second. It's supposed to be classic level jump for the lower level and traditional level jump on the higher level of these jumps. That is my belief. I'm not sure, though. So yeah, what you're going to want to do is take 6 popsicle sticks, get rid of some cell here, and cut off the ends of them. So after you've cut off all the ends, you are going to connect them together to make the jump standards. I'm leaving the other ends circular now. I don't know if I'll change that later, but we're just going to see. So take 3 of them, and what you're going to do is kind of lay them like that. So that makes sense. You're going to glue it just like that. Line up these ends and glue it just like that. While the hot glue gun's warming up, I'm going to measure out these little stubs. So just take a few old piece of popsicle stick from a previous project. If you don't have any, just obviously cut up a popsicle stick. They don't have to have rounded ends. So what you're going to do is take a jump standard popsicle stick and line it up like this on the edge and just draw a little mark with a pencil or pen where it meets up right there. Alright, then with your scissors, cut right at that mark. Hold it tightly so it doesn't bend or break. Then you have these little tiny rectangles. And what's going to happen with those is they're going to be what holds the poles in the jump standards, because we're going to connect them just like that, really, and then it'll make more sense in a second. So once you have this part glued together, it should stand. You can choose to paint it now. I'm going to paint it in a second. What you can do is sand down the sides, just because if you have some little bubbles from the hot glue, then you want to get those away before you paint it. But now we're going to measure out the spots for these little pieces that we cut to just slide right in there. You could choose to cut these off. I think I'm actually going to cut off the round parts. I didn't really like them very much. So I'm going to do 3 of these little pieces. So I'm going to measure where I'd want them. So maybe centimeters here. Possibly if it goes up to 12, so every 4. Actually, I think I'm going to do every 3 would be good, because I don't want it to go all the way to the top. So make a mark at 3. Make another mark at 6. Make another mark at 9. Should line up pretty well. Yep. So those are where we're going to slide in these guys. Might even do... not sure. Might do a 12. I'll just see how it goes. Alright, so now what you're going to do is glue in these little pieces where you marked it on both of the jump. So now you should have 2 jump standards, kind of. They're still in the making. If you line them up, they should be fairly similar, where they'll hold the poles. I mean, my top one is definitely off. I don't know how that happens. Bottom 2 are fine. You can add more little shelves almost. They do look like little shelves. And I changed the tops. I cut them at angles and then I kept it straight at the top, just because I think it looks a little bit better. So now with the popsicle stick or 2 you have left, we are going to make bases for the jump standards so they don't fall over super easily. So how you're going to do this is we're going to split this popsicle stick into, like, thirds. That makes sense. Kind of like what you see in this picture, sort of. And I'll show you how to do that. The first thing you're going to want to do is, again, cut off one end of the popsicle stick. And just kind of even that out here with some sandpaper. It's actually a really bad end I cut. Sorry. So that's better. Alright, so... once that's evened out, take one of the jump standards and line it up with the end. And you're just going to cut off a little bit more like this. I'm thinking possibly just 2 of the links here. that makes any sense. So if you measure this, mine are pretty much 2 centimeters. So we'd do double that, and we'd cut this at 4 centimeters. And I'm just going to mark that off at 4 centimeters. All right, cut that. Oops. And glue that. You could do front and back now. Just going to glue that to the side. And we're going to go all the way around like that. And then we'll do another one here, and another one here, and another one here. And that will ensure that it stands up and doesn't fall over that easily. So yeah, just cut 8 more of these, or 7 more of these.
I'm waking up to ash and dust. I wipe my brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals. I'm breaking in, shaping up, then checking out on the prison bus. This is it, the apocalypse. Whoa, I'm waking up.
So from here you could be done if you wanted to. You could set up the jumps and put in poles to make a nice jump. I can't do this with one hand. There you have a nice jump. Or if you want, you can paint it white or whatever color you prefer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint these standards white, and I'm going to paint the poles striped, and I'll show you how those turn out.